हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द वर्चुअल क्लास ऑफ कॉरपोरेट अकाउंटिंग। एट प्रेजेंट वी आर डिस्कसिंग एन इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक कॉल्ड रिडेम्पशन ऑफ रिडीमेबल प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स। इन प्रीवियस ऑल लेक्चर्स आई हैव discussed practicals with full length and we have covered almost all adjustments. So today in this session, say last session of the chapter, I would like to discuss one more important question with so many important concepts. This is my humble request to you all to concentrate on each and every important calculations and concept, because this question is exhaustive in nature. Specifically, redemption of RPS is concerned. Let us refer the question first. On your screen, you can see a balance sheet of Sun Moon Limited as on 31st March 2019. As usual, on liability side, equity share capital, redeemable preference share capital, general reserve, profit and loss account, creditors and bills payable are given. But on liability side, there are two different surprising items available to us. The first surprising item is the company has called rupees 2 earlier from the shareholders, not right now, but in past. But a few shareholders failed to pay amount, and this amount is available on liability side of the balance sheet as calls in arrears. And second surprising item is amount of RPS redemption premium. Generally, during the process of RPS redemption, we need to adjust RPS redemption premium against security premium account or profit and loss account. But in this question, RPS redemption premium is already available to us on liabilities side of the balance sheet. It means the company has already dedicated amount of RPS redemption premium, and it is already available to us on liabilities side of the balance sheet. So in this question, we are not supposed to contribute amount from security premium and profit and loss account to adjust amount of RPS redemption premium. So these two items are new on liability side of the balance sheet, and these items have significant impact, very much effect on our calculation. So take care of these things very carefully. On asset side of the building, we have land and building, plant, goodwill, bank balance, debtors, bills receivable, and last amount representing inventory, that is stock. Total of the balance sheet on both the sides, rupees 32,16,000. Let us move to the additional information. The preference shareholders whose calls are in arrears were served due notices and their shares were forfeited for non-payment of calls. Refer the balance sheet again. Here we have calls in arrears for rupees 4000 at the rate of rupees 2 per share. Company has given notice to them and they have not paid amount to the company and the company forfeited their shares. For the purpose of redemption, the company issued 600 equity shares to shareholders at 25% premium on right basis. In previous many questions, we have discussed number of shares issued by the company. But in this question, number of shares issued by the company are given to us in a ready-made form. The company has issued 600 equity shares, face value is rupees 100, and the company has issued shares at 25% premium on right basis. Right shares means the first right given to existing shareholders of the company for purchasing new equity shares. But this particular method doesn't make any difference in our calculation. For us, amount is given by the existing shareholders or new shareholders. Ultimately, we are in receipt of the amount when we issue new equity shares. The company received amount of the shares. The payment was made on September 30, 2019 with the dividend due. In previous all the questions, the year was ending on 31st March and on very next day, that's a 1st April, the company redeemed their shares. So there were no issue of the gap or duration between year ending and the payment date. Here, our year ending on 31st March, but we have paid our shareholders on September 30. So we need to pay them dividend for the period. So this is also new item for you all. Thereafter, on 31st December 2019, the company issued fully paid up bonus shares to the equity shareholders from its capitalized profit and balance from revenue profit in the ratio of one share for every three shares held. After redemption of preference shares, the company has decided to issue bonus share in the ratio of 3:1. For every three shares held, the company has declared one bonus share. For this purpose, we need to utilize all capitalized profit first. And after that, if we need the amount, we can utilize balance from revenue profit. So again, this is a technical part incorporated by the examiner. What to do? You are required to pass journal entries and prepare the balance sheet of the company as on 31st December 2019. I hope everybody is clear with the technical aspect of the question. Let us move to the solution of the problem. Same as a previous question, in this question, number of shares are not given. So let us calculate number of shares. equity shares 15 lakhs rupees 100 per share. 15 lakhs divided by 100 rupees per share. So number of equity shares are 15,000. 11% RPS. 4 lakhs rupees divided by amount called up per share rupees 8. So 50,000 shares. In addition to number of equity shares and preference shares, in this particular question, we need to calculate number of preference shares on which calls are in arrears. So let us calculate number of RPS on which calls are in arrears, means amount not paid by the shareholders. Check liability side of the balance sheet. On liability side, it is given that amount of calls in arrears is rupees 4,000 and per share rupees 2. So 4,000 rupees calls in arrears, rupees 2 per share. It means the company has not received that call on 2,000 numbers of redeemable preference shares. Just keep numbers of equity shares 15,000, number of 11% RPS 50,000, of which number of RPS on which calls are in arrears 2,000. Let us move to the most important part of this question related to forfeiture of 11% RPS. As per the information, the company has decided to forfeit the shares on which calls are in arrears. So we have already completed number of shares in previous calculation. So we need to forfeit 2,000 redeemable preference shares. Let us check liability side of the balance sheet. On liability side of the balance sheet, it is clearly mentioned that the company has called up rupees 8 per share on 11% redeemable preference shares. So total amount called up by the company 16,000. Out of 16,000 rupees, 4,000 rupees are in arrears. Matlab, company ne abhi tak 16,000 ki demand ki hai. 2,000 shares ke jo malik the, unhone 4,000 rupaye ki payment karne ki na kar di hai. Iska matlab, out of 16,000, calls in arrears are 4,000. So amount received by the company on these 2,000 shares are rupees 12,000. As you all know, on the occasion of forfeiture, whatever the amount received by the company from the shareholder till the date of forfeiture is forfeited. It means अभी तक shareholders ने जो amount company को दी है, वो सारी amount पे company कब्जा कर लेगी. Company ये amount shareholders को वापस नहीं करेगी. So, let us pass journal entry for this transaction. 11% RPS capital account debited, as we have computed over here, 16,000. To share forfeiture account 12,000 टू कॉल्स इन एरियर्स अकाउंट 4000, 16000 कैपिटल अब कैंसल होगी बिकॉज वी हैव फॉरफिटेड 2000 नंबर ऑफ आरपीएस, 4000 अमाउंट ऑफ कॉल्स इन एरियर्स मीन्स अमाउंट नॉट रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम द शेयर होल्डर्स. सो आउट ऑफ 16000 4000 इज कॉल्स इन एरियर्स, सो अमाउंट रिसीव्ड बाय द कंपनी इज रुपीज 12000 एंड इट इज फॉरफिटेड बाय द कंपनी. विद दिस द प्रोसेस ऑफ फॉरफीचर कम्स टू एन एंड. बट कीप वन थिंग इन योर माइंड, दिस प्रोसेस ऑफ फॉरफीचर विल अफेक्ट रेस्ट ऑफ द कैलक्यूलेशन रिलेटेड टू आरपीएस रिडम्पशन. लेट अस मूव टू द प्रोसेस ऑफ आरपीएस रिडम्पशन. हियर वी नीड टू कैलक्यूलेट नंबर ऑफ रिडीमेबल प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स रिडीम्ड बाय द कंपनी. आप एक सेकेंड में बोल दोगे कि भाई कंपनी ने 50000 प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स इश्यू किए हैं तो कंपनी पूरे के पूरे 50000 शेयर्स वापस करेगी. दिस इज अवर जनरल बिलीफ दैट द कंपनी हैज इश्यूड 50000 रिडीमेबल प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स, सो कंपनी विल रिडीम ऑल 50000 प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स. नो, इन दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर ऑफ शेयर्स forfeited by the company playing important role, or you can say it is a turning point of our calculation. Number of preference shares issued by the company 50000, of which company already forfeited 2000 shares. Company ne 2000 shares jabt kar liye hain. तो जो शेयर्स कंपनी ने जब्त कर ही लिए हैं उसे वापस करने की कोई संभावना है ही नहीं. इट मींस दैट द नंबर ऑफ प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स रिडीम्ड बाय द कंपनी इज 48000. इफ यू कैलक्यूलेट एवरीथिंग रिलेटेड टू दिस 50000, योर आंसर इज एब्सोल्यूटली रॉन्ग right from the first stage. So let us understand, total shares of 50000, of which 2000 shares are forfeited by the company. So number of shares redeemed by the company 48000, means we need to plan entire redemption process for 48000 shares only. So keep this figure in your mind and let us move toward first step of redemption of preference shares. Step number one, make a call to convert partly paid shares into fully paid. 11% RPS as per the information given on liability side, face value of the share is rupees 10, paid up value of the share is rupees 8. After calculation of these many questions, now you can easily say that these preference shares are partly paid. So it is a compulsory for us to make a final call of rupees 2 per share on 48000 shares. Why? We have already forfeited 2000 number of shares. जिस शेयर पर हमने कब्जा कर ही लिया है अब उनको ये तो नहीं बोल सकते कि भाई आपके 2 रुपए बाकी आप दे दो. As we have already forfeited 2000 preference shares, we cannot make any call on them. So now our account is moving around 48000 shares only. अब हमें ये याद रखना है कि हमारे preference shares की संख्या 50000 नहीं है, Now they are only 48,000. 48,000 multiplied by rupees 2 per share. So amount receivable on a final call 96,000. Let us pass journal entry in two parts as we have discussed earlier. Final call on preference shares account debited 96,000 to 11% RPS capital account 96,000. And all the shareholders of the company have given due amount to the company on final call. So amount received by the company is also rupees 96,000. Journal entry, bank account debited 96,000 to final call on preference shares account 96,000. Right now we are passing journal entry just to confirm your accounting treatment, but at the end we need to prepare a systematic statement in order to complete our answer. So with these entries we have made our final call and we have also received amount on final call. Let us move to step number 2. Step number 2 is all about amount payable to shareholders. Number of RPS redeemable by the company. Again, the same figure, 48,000. 11% RPS capital, 48,000 shares multiplied by face value of the share, rupees 10. So amount payable to the shareholders, rupees 4,80,000. Plus, we need to pay amount as RPS redemption premium. But in this question, the provision for RPS redemption of premium is already made by the company. And this amount is appeared on liability side of the balance sheet given in the question. So visit the question once in order to find out amount of RPS redemption premium. When you check liability side of the balance sheet, you will come to know that amount of RPS redemption premium is rupees 20,000. But these 20,000 is for 50,000 shares. Company ko pehle se to pata nahi tha ki 2000 shares jinke paas hai wo call nahi denge, hum unko forfeit karenge. Ye sab kuch company ko pehle se pata nahi hota hai. So company under the impression that we need to redeem 20,000 rupees as a premium on 50,000 shares. So company ne pehle se hi 50,000 shares ke liye provision karke rakha tha. So we need to utilize this amount proportionately. 20,000 rupees given for 50,000 shares. So now we need to redeem only 48,000 shares. So 48,000 shares is equal to 19,200. It is simply a cross multiplication. When shares are 50,000, amount is 20,000. When shares are 48,000, amount is how much? So the total amount payable to RPS holders, 4,80,000 for capital, 19,200 rupees as RPS redemption premium. So total 4,99,200. Let us pass journal entry for this transaction. 11% RPS capital account debited, 4,80,000 RPS redemption premium account debited, 19,200 to RPS holders account, 4,99,200. In this question, in addition to the share and redemption premium, we need to pay one more amount to RPS holders. Refer additional information. In additional information, it is clearly mentioned that till the date of redemption, we need to pay redemption premium, capital, and in addition to these amounts, we need to pay dividend for due period. So let us calculate due period. 31st March 2019, it is the date of balance sheet. So from 1st April 2019 to September 30, 2019, April, May, June, July, August, and September. So the period is 6 months. It means we need to pay dividend on these preference shares for the period of 6 months. 48,000 shares, क्योंकि 2,000 तो already जब्त हो चुके हैं, multiplied by called up capital per share ₹8, multiplied by 6 months, the period due over here, and the rate of dividend is 11%. So we need to pay 21,120 rupees to our shareholders as dividend. In previous all questions, we have paid capital and redemption premium. But in this question, the examiner has added one more adjustment related to payment to RPS holders. As we all know that dividend is always declared by the company out of the profit. So let us pass journal entry. Profit and loss account debited 21,120 to dividend on RPS account 21,120, being amount of dividend payable to RPS holders. You just make it correct in a big amount of dividend payable to RPS holders. In this question, we need to pay dividend of rupees 21,120 to the shareholders. After calculation of amount payable to shareholders, let us move towards most important adjustment. It is all about arrangement of fund for capital part. For capital part, we need total amount of rupees 4,80,000. And as per information clearly mentioned that the company has issued new equity shares at 25% premium. And number of shares issued by the company is also given as 600. So for this adjustment, we are not in need of any kind of technical calculations because everything is given in ready-made form. 600 equity shares issued by the company multiplied by 100 rupees each. So total 60,000. Premium is least concern over here. So 100 rupees, 60,000. Total amount required for lakhs 80,000. Amount collected by the company issuing new securities 60,000. So rest of the amount transferred to capital redemption reserve, CRR account. Check liability side of the balance sheet given in our question. Amount of general reserve is more than enough. मतलब हमारे पास general reserve में बहुत सारा fund है. So we can utilize our general reserve in order to redeem our RPS utilizing or creating capital redemption reserve. So 4,20,000 rupees transferred from general reserve. Let us pass entry for this transaction. First of all, issue the bonus shares. Issue the new shares, 600 shares of rupees 100 each at 25% premium. So bank account debited rupees 75,000 to equity share capital account rupees 60,000 to securities premium account 600 shares multiplied by 25 rupees, that is 15,000. Total amount received by the company 75,000, of which 60,000 is for capital and 15,000 for security premium. Let us transfer amount to capital redemption reserve, that is CRR. General reserve account debited 4,20,000 to capital redemption reserve account 4,20,000. We have transferred 4,20,000 from general reserve to capital redemption reserve. So with these entries, adjustment for capital part comes to an end. Let us enter into most important calculation, concept or understanding related to our question. In this question, amount required for RPS redemption is rupees 19,200 that we have completed in calculation, or you can say step number 2. Amount redeemable to RPS holders. We have already completed a calculation related to RPS redemption premium over there. Now check. Very first time the amount of RPS redemption premium is given in the balance sheet. And the amount of premium is rupees 20,000. Matlab, the company has already contributed rupees 20,000 to redeem RPS in previous years, any of the year. So it is least concern for us right now. Of which now we need only rupees 19,200. Company ne pehle se hi 20,000 ki vyavastha karke rakhi hai. Lekin ab hume 20,000 nahi chahiye. We need only 19,200. So we need not to manage anything because this amount is already managed by the company in previous years. If you fail to understand this amount and this particular adjustment that it is already given in the balance sheet, as per routine, will transfer the amount either from security premium account or from profit and loss account to adjust the amount. But keep this thing in your mind. Aur aap acche se samjho. Agar hamare paas paisa nahi hai, to hame uski arrangement karni hai. लेकिन अगर हमारे पास वो अमाउंट, वो अरेंजमेंट पहले से ही हो चुकी है, देन वी आर नॉट सपोज टू अरेंज एनीथिंग। यहां पे कुछ उल्टा होगा, उल्टा ये होगा कि हमने अरेंजमेंट की थी 20,000 की, वी हैव ऑलरेडी अरेंज्ड फंड फॉर रुपीज 20,000, बट वी नीड ओनली 19,200, सो वी हैव सरप्लस अमाउंट इन अवर आरपीएस रिडम्पशन प्रीमियम अकाउंट। नाउ दीज एडिशनल अमाउंट ऑफ आरपीएस रिडम्पशन प्रीमियम इज ऑफ नो यूज। क्यों? आरपीएस रिडम्पशन प्रीमियम एक ऐसा स्पेशल रिजर्व है जो कंपनी सिर्फ आरपीएस रिडम्पशन के लिए ही करती है। एक बार आरपीएस का रिडम्पशन हो जाने के बाद हमें उस अमाउंट की आज, कल, परसों, नरसों, जिंदगी में कभी भी जरूरत नहीं है, क्योंकि जिस काम के लिए पैसे हमने अलग रखे थे वो काम अब खत्म हो गया है। तो काम खत्म होने के बाद हमारे पास ये जो अमाउंट बची है उसका हम क्या करेंगे? दिस अमाउंट इज ट्रांसफर्ड टू कैपिटल रिडम्पशन प्रीमियम टू कैपिटल रिजर्व अकाउंट। वी हैव टू डिफरेंट ट्रांजेक्शन्स इन अवर प्रीवियस कैलक्युलेशन दैट वी नीड टू ट्रांसफर टू अ स्पेशलाइज्ड अकाउंट कॉल्ड कैपिटल प्रॉफिट और कैपिटल रिजर्व अकाउंट। लेट अस चेक दिस टू ट्रांजेक्शन। इन वेरी फर्स्ट एंट्री वी हैव फॉरफिटेड द शेयर्स एंड इन दैट फॉरफिचर वी हैव फॉरफिटेड ₹12,000 फ्रॉम शेयर होल्डर्स। राइट फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 12th शेयर कैपिटल ट्रांजेक्शन दिस एंट्री इज इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इन अकाउंटिंग रिलेटेड टू फॉरफिचर ऑफ शेयर्स। वंस यू फॉरफिट एनी अमाउंट आफ्टर यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ दिस अमाउंट वॉट एवर द अमाउंट रेस्ट विद द कंपनी इट इज ट्रांसफर्ड टू कैपिटल रिजर्व। सो वी नीड टू ट्रांसफर ₹12,000 टू कैपिटल रिजर्व फ्रॉम अमाउंट फॉरफिटेड बाय द कंपनी एंड ₹800 एडिशनल अमाउंट ऑफ आरपीएस रिडम्पशन प्रीमियम। लेट अस पास जर्नल एंट्री। शेयर फॉरफीचर अकाउंट डेबिटेड ₹12,000, आरपीएस रिडम्पशन प्रीमियम अकाउंट डेबिटेड ₹800 टू कैपिटल रिजर्व अकाउंट ₹12,800। अमाउंट ऑफ शेयर फॉर फ्यूचर एंड अनयूटिलाइज्ड आरपीएस रिडम्पशन प्रीमियम ट्रांसफर्ड टू कैपिटल रिजर्व अकाउंट। आपको यह लगता होगा कि पिछले किसी क्वेश्चन में और इस चैप्टर के किसी और क्वेश्चन में यह ट्रांजैक्शन तो नहीं था। आप सही सोच रहे हो, क्योंकि किसी और क्वेश्चन में रिडीमेबल प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स फॉर फ्यूचर ट्रांजेक्शन्स इनकॉर्पोरेट नहीं हुआ था। पिछले किसी भी क्वेश्चन में बैलेंस शीट में आरपीएस रिडम्पशन प्रीमियम की अमाउंट नहीं दी गई थी। इन दिस क्वेश्चन टू डिफरेंट ट्रांजेक्शन्स इन्वॉल्व। फर्स्ट नंबर ऑफ शेयर्स फॉरफिटेड बाय द कंपनी एंड सेकेंड अमाउंट ऑफ आरपीएस रिडम्पशन प्रीमियम गिवन ऑन लायबिलिटी साइड ऑफ द बैलेंस शीट। एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस फॉरफिचर एंड एवरीथिंग वी नीड टू ट्रांसफर अमाउंट टू कैपिटल रिजर्व अकाउंट ₹12,800। आई होप All of you are clear with these concepts and understanding. Now we are ready to pay amount to shareholders. Let us pay amount to shareholders. We need to pay 4,80,000 for capital, 19,200 for redemption premium. So total amount 4,99,200 for capital and redemption premium. But in this question, we need to pay one more amount to the company, that is dividend for the period of 6 months. We have already completed this calculation at the time of calculation of amount payable to the shareholders in two different parts. First part, capital and redemption premium, and second part, we have completed calculation for dividend. So in this way, total amount paid to the shareholders comes to rupees 5,20,320. Let us pay amount to shareholders. RPS holders account debited 4,99,200. Dividend on a preference shares account debited 21,120 to bank account 5,20,320. With this, transaction related to payment to RPS holders comes to an end. Let us enter into one more important and interesting transaction incorporated in this particular question. This transaction is related to bonus. As per information available to us in additional information part, for this question, arrangement of fund for bonus is also interesting. Number of equity shares available to us as on 31st March 2019, 15,000. These number of shares are given in the balance sheet. On September 30, the company has issued 600 number of equity shares in order to redeem the RPS. So total number of shares are 15,000 plus 600. The ratio of bonus issue is 3:1. It means one bonus equity share is issued for 3 equity shares held. So for 15,600 number of shares, number of bonus shares issued by the company 5,200. I would like to draw your attention that in previous all the question, all transactions happened on same date. Redemption on 1st April, bonus on 1st April. Here, the year ending on 31st March. New shares issued by the company on September 30. And bonus issued by the company on December 31st, 2019. Check the question very carefully. It means when we calculate number of shares on 31st December 2019, they are 15,600. जब मैं 31 दिसंबर को नंबर ऑफ शेयर्स की कैलकुलेशंस करूंगा तब मेरे ध्यान में नंबर ऑफ शेयर्स आएंगे 15,600 एज ऑन 31st March, 600 इश्यूड ऑन सितंबर 30. सो 15,600 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1/3, 5,200. 200. Therefore, amount required 5,200 bonus shares of rupees 100 each, 5,20,000. Now, refer additional information again. In additional information, it is mentioned that company will utilize first capitalized profit, and after utilization of the capitalized profit, if company is in need of anything else, then we can manage from revenue profit. Pehle company capitalized profit ka istemal karegi aur phir bhi amount ki zarurat hai, then company will think on revenue profit. So we need to collect this 5,20,000 very carefully. Let us see. Total requirement 5,20,000. We have CRR of rupees 4,20,000. You can check these 4,20,000 rupees in step number 3. Arrangement of fund for capital part. Right? So we have collected this amount. Then in a previous calculation, we have completed a calculation and transferred to capital reserve 12,000 rupees amount forfeited by the company, 800 rupees unutilized RPS redemption premium. So it is also contributed for the bonus. Still amount is not enough. So we will utilize securities premium. In our balance sheet, amount of security premium is not given. But when we have issued 600 equity shares of rupees 100 each at 25% premium, in order to redeem RPS, we have received security premium of rupees 15,000. 4,20,000 plus 12,800 plus 15,000. We need rupees 5,20,000. But still, we need 72,200 more. So these 72,200 is contributed from revenue profit as per information given. So we need to utilize amount of general reserve in order to arrange the fund. Suppose amount of general reserve is not enough to meet the requirement, then we have to use credit balance of profit and loss account. I hope everybody is clear with the adjustment related to arrangement of the fund for issue of bonus shares. Let us move to the next item. Journal entry for this transaction is capital redemption reserve account debited 4,20,000, 12,800 rupees from capital reserve account, securities premium account debited by 15,000, and we have utilized our general reserve for 72,200 to bonus to shareholders account. Utilizing capital redemption reserve, securities premium and general reserve, we have declared bonus. And second entry, bonus to shareholders account debited 5,20,000 to equity share capital account 5,20,000. With this, our all journal entries comes to an end. Let us arrange all journal entries in systematic format. Shares forfeited by the company, amount received on final call, amount payable to RPS holders for capital part and premium part, amount of dividend payable to the shareholders, issue of new equity shares in order to redeem RPS, amount transferred to general reserve account to capital redemption reserve account, amount transferred to capital reserve account from share forfeiture and additional amount of RPS redemption premium, amount paid to RPS holders, bonus shares declared by the company out of CRR, capital reserve, securities premium and general reserve, and bonus equity shares issued by the company. This is nothing more than repetitions of the earlier calculation and journal entries. But as a part of the answer, we need to arrange everything in a systematic manner so as we can score marks in full. Let us move to the last part of our answer, and it is all about preparation of the balance sheet in vertical form. Last part of our answer, it is vertical balance sheet. Equity and liabilities. Number one is all about shareholders fund. Shareholders fund includes amount of share capital. Amount of share capital is ₹20,80,000. Let us calculate amount of share capital. In the balance sheet, equity share capital is given as 15 lakhs and preference share capital is given as 3,96,000. But during the process of redemption, we have made some adjustments. So let us refer equity share capital first. Existing number of shares 15,000 multiplied by 100. So existing equity share capital is ₹15 lakhs given in the balance sheet. During the process of RPS redemption, we have issued 600 new equity shares. So amount received by the company for new equity share capital is ₹60,000. You can confirm this figure with the calculation number 3. Bonus shares issued in step number 6, 5,20,000. So 20,80,000 rupees for share capital that we have inserted over here. Preference shares already redeemed by the company, so there is no issue to incorporate any preference shares in new balance sheet. Reserves and surplus 4,86,680. Let us move towards the calculation. General reserve You can check the balance sheet. Amount given is rupees 8 lakhs. We have transferred rupees 4,20,000 to CRR. Refer step number 3 in order to find out amount of 4,20,000. We have utilized rupees 72,200 to issue the bonus. You can check this figure in step number 6 that we have discussed with the presentation of the chart. We have to utilize all capital profit first and remaining amount transferred from general reserve. So out of 8 lakhs, these two items are deducted. So the balance of a general reserve account is 3,07,800. We have transferred 4,20,000 to CRR. But we have utilized all 4,20,000 for bonus. So balance is zero. Security is a premium account that we have received in a new issue. In the balance sheet, it is not given. We have received in a new issue 15,000. And we have utilized for a bonus 15,000. So the balance of security premium account is zero. Capital reserve 12,000 for amount forfeited, 800 rupees for additional RPS redemption premium. Total 12,800. This 12,800 is also utilized for the purpose of bonus. So zero. Profit and loss account, amount given in the balance sheet over here, 2 lakhs. So this is 2 lakhs. And declaration of dividend by the company to the RPS holders, 21,120. So the balance amount of profit and loss account is 1,78,880. Take care of this thing very clearly. Total of reserves and surplus 4,86,680. It is inserted over here. Step number 2 in liability side. Other current liabilities. We have prepared a separate note for the calculation of other current liabilities. This is a balance sheet given on liability side of the balance sheet. Current liability includes 1,80,000 rupees for creditors and 1,20,000 rupees for bills payable. You can easily connect these two items. See, check it. So total amount is 3 lakhs that we are supposed to transfer at our balance sheet. So move to the balance sheet. 3 lakhs rupees. Total of the liability side 28,66,680. Second part of the balance sheet, it is all about assets. The first asset is non-current asset. Non-current asset means fixed asset. It includes fixed assets tangible 19 lakhs and fixed assets intangible 1 lakh. In order to understand this calculation, visit the balance sheet given in the question. This is asset side of the balance sheet. On asset side of the balance sheet, it is clearly mentioned that land and building is given for 10 lakhs, plant is given for 9 lakhs. So total is 19 lakhs. Goodwill It is a part of non-current assets, intangible. So 1 lakh, 10 lakhs rupees shifted over here, 9 lakhs rupees shifted over here, and this goodwill is transferred under intangible assets. It is inserted in the balance sheet. And the last item of this balance sheet is all about current asset. Amount of current asset is 8,66,680. In this question, calculation of current asset is also important, because in previous questions that we have discussed, information related to bank balance was either calculated earlier or given by the examiner in a ready-made form as a part of maintenance of the closing bank balance like this. But here we need to prepare a systematic statement in order to calculate bank balance. Opening bank balance is given over here in the balance sheet, 4,18,000. Here we need to recall all the transactions very properly. Bank balance 4,18,000, right? So be very much clear with this solution. Final call on RPS, we have received 96,000 on 48,000 shares at the rate of rupees 2. You can check step number 1, amount received on final call. Then we have received 75,000 rupees on issue of 600 equity shares of rupees 100 each at 25% premium. 600 shares multiplied by 100 rupees equals to 60,000 for capital, and 25%, that is 15,000 rupees for premium. So in this way we have received rupees 75,000. So total amount of receipt is rupees 5,89,000, out of which we have paid 5,20,320 rupees to the shareholders for RPS capital, RPS redemption premium and dividend that we need to pay. So total amount of bank balance at the end is rupees 68,680. I hope everybody is clear with this calculation. After calculation of bank balance, we need to calculate our current assets. Bank balance 68,680 that we have completed over here. Debtors 3,46,000 directly from here. Bills receivable 54,000 from here, and inventory or stock 3,98,000. So total of the current asset is 8,66,680. It is transferred to the asset side as note number 6 under current asset. So total of the balance sheet for asset part is 28,66,680. So our balance sheet is settled on asset side as well as liability side. If you settle your balance sheet very properly in the examination with all the calculations, you can score marks in full. So take care of these things very properly. I hope everybody is clear with all the steps, all the concepts, all the aspects of this question. Again, I request you to watch this video and simultaneously calculate in your book twice, thrice, or as much as possible time in order to secure 20 marks in full. This is last question of the chapter Redemption of RPS. Refer all other questions one by one again to revise the chapter very carefully. Prepare your own notes and solve rest of the questions given in your book. I am 100% sure that after watching solution of all the problems in the video one by one, simultaneously preparation of your notes, now you are capable enough to answer any question in final examination with all concepts. Thank you. God bless you. Keep learning. Keep growing. See you in next virtual class with new chapter. Thank you once again.